and gentlemen, in the next adventure of the Shadow, as in all his adventures, the news about his exploits are often known to the underworld almost as soon as they happen. And I want to tell you that the news about the new Goodrich Silvertown tire is traveling like wildfire among motorists all over America. It's because this new Silvertown is so sensational in action and appearance, it's really a new kind of tire. You've never seen anything like it. It even looks different. For its tread is wider and flatter, and every inch of the tread is covered with row upon row of never-ending spiral bars. And those spiral bars do the same job on a wet, slippery road as your windshield wiper does to your windshield. They sweep the water right and left. They force the water out through the deep drainage groove. Thanks to that lifesaver tread, your tire actually has a drier, safer road surface for the rubber to grip. Just think over it. Here is a tread that's actually a road dryer. No wonder the new Silvertown will stop you quicker and protect you against the dangers of skidding as never before. And here's a sincere and friendly tip. Don't fail to see and drive on the new Goodrich Silvertown the very first chance you get. Get a free demonstration. Take it from me, you'll get the driving thrill of a lifetime. And remember, only the new Silvertown offers you two great life-saving features. Lifesaver Tread Skid Protection and the famous Golden Fly Blowout Protection at no extra cost. The Shadow, Lamont Cranston, a man of wealth, a student of science, and a master of other people's minds, devotes his life to righting wrongs, protecting the innocent, and punishing the guilty. Using advanced methods that may ultimately become available to all law enforcement agencies, Cranston is known to the underworld as the Shadow. Never seen, only heard. As haunting to superstitious minds as a ghost. As inevitable as a guilty conscience. The Shadow's true identity is known only to his constant friend and aide, Margot Lane. Today's story, The Power of the Mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's a special radio flash on the mysterious disappearance of Professor John Hardy. He was last seen entering a black limousine and was accompanied by a heavy-set man wearing a Van Dyke beard and a tall, slender woman of foreign appearance. Secret Service agents are reported investigating the case, due to the importance attached to the professor's reported discovery of a new type explosive, more powerful than any known to munition makers in any country in the world.
Come in. Come into my cabin, dear Countess Ella.
Well, Richter, as your very stubborn and courageous American inventor talks, isn't you the formula for that high explosive he so determined shall fall into no other hands save his own government?
No, but he will. He can't stand much more of Ivan's treatment with a whip.
Be careful. Too much torture can destroy the mind. And if Professor Harvey's mind snaps, you will never get the formula. Because we know for certain he has never written it down.
I know. I have warned Ivan to be careful.
Ivan's idea of care is to see how close he can come to whipping a man to death without actually doing so. Why do you keep that big brute as a bodyguard? He has the mind of a child.
In our business of espionage, Countess Anna, it is often useful to have servants who cannot think for themselves. Besides, Ivan is rather cunning in an animal sort of way. Did you hear that? Success at last, my dear Countess. I think Professor Hardy is ready to give us the formula.
I'll tell you where I hid the gold. I found it, but I hid it. I found it at the end of the rainbow, and I hid it.
I hid it, but I'll tell you.
Victor, I warned you, his mind is snapped.
Here, man, you fool. I told you to be clever. Give me that whip. I told you.
I don't strike him hard. I don't.
Oh, stop it. What good will it do you to beat Ivan? He doesn't even feel it. It's your fault. You should have watched him better.
So you're telling me what to do, are you, Congress?
It's about time someone did. You've certainly bungled this. Now how are you going to get the formula? A man's out of his mind. No amount of physical posture can make him tell us.
Take him back to the hold of the shipping one.
I obey. Come, Professor. Come with me.
So, you've destroyed his mind. Good work. Like having a formula in a sealed envelope and throwing it in the fire. Now, what are you going to report to headquarters?
Be quiet, Dara. I'm not finished. There's still a chance. Another way of getting his secret out of him. Even if his mind is gone. It may be an easier, surer way. Oh, why didn't I think of it before?
What are you talking about? How can there be any other way with his mind destroyed by days and days of Yvonne's fiendish torture with the whip?
Dara, it so happens that a fellow countryman of mine, Dr. Von Beck, one of the world's greatest psychiatrists, is in this country, right here in the city.
And I suppose he'll gladly come down to the ship, the Star of Zealand, and get Professor Harvey's secrets from him for you.
No, not gladly, perhaps, my dear Countess. But he will come. Just what you see.
I enjoyed your lecture very much, Dr. Waldeck. Our club has been honored tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Cranston. You are a scientist interested in psychiatry?
Well, in a way, Dr. Waldeck, I'm really only an amateur criminologist.
So, then perhaps you could tell me something of this remarkable man I've heard so much about. Even before I made this trip to America, a man called The Shadow.
The Shadow? I'm afraid not, Doctor. No one knows very much about him. Have you heard?
Oh, a great deal. I understand he is a master of mass hypnosis, of mental suggestion. He has you criminals and police quite baffled by his ability to appear in a room crowded, as let us say, this club of yours, and yet remain unseen.
You seem to have no doubt of the Shadow's existence, his powers, Doctor.
Oh, none whatever, Mr. Cranston. In fact, I should like to meet this Shadow. but then I suppose I should have to commit some crime in order to do so, and I wouldn't care to carry my scientific research quite that far.
I think the Shadow would enjoy meeting you, Doctor. We have much in common. I think you would be profoundly interested in your work in psychic research, particularly in the field of mental telepathy. You know, it might be interesting if you and the Shadow could make a test of thought transmission with a purely mental telepathic method.
It would indeed. the Shadow, from what I hear, he has little time for theory. He deals mainly in the harsh realities of criminal investigation.
Yes, but the two pursuits are not as far removed from each other as some persons seem to think.
Dr. Waldeck.
Right here, John. A message for you, Doctor.
Here you are, Doctor. Gentleman and the lady are waiting outside in their car.
Oh, thank you. That's unusual. Most unusual.
Any answer, Doctor?
Answer? Yes. Say to the Countess I will come immediately.
All right.
I will do what I can. You will excuse me, Mr. Cranston. A countrywoman of mine is in need of help, and I must go at once. Perhaps we will meet again.
Come in.
So here you are, Lamont Cranston. I thought you promised to take me to dinner tonight. You're an hour late.
I know. I'm terribly sorry, Margot.
You're sorry, but Margot Lane, your assistant, is hungry. What's the matter, Lamont? You seem preoccupied. Was anything troubling you?
Yes, Margaret, something is troubling me, but I'm just... I don't know what it is.
Would it be Dr. Waldeck? Ever since you talked to him at the club last night, you've been wondering if he just suspected that you were the Shadow.
I don't think he knows, Margaret.
Then what are you worrying about?
Simply that all day long I've had the feeling that Dr. Waldeck has been trying to get in touch with me, or rather, I should say, with the Shadow.
But how could he?
Waldeck practiced what he preached. He is a master of mental telepathy.
Well, the Shadow isn't exactly a novice at mental telepathy either. What makes you think he's trying to get in touch with
me? At intervals, all day, my mind has kept reverting to thoughts of distress, coupled with Waldeck's name. Waldeck's name and another name. Star of Zealand.
That sounds like the name of a ship.
Perhaps, but it doesn't make sense.
Well, it seems to me it'd be easy to find out if Dr. Waldeck's in trouble. Why not call his hotel?
I've been on the point of doing it several times, but...
Here, give me that phone. Let me call him. The trouble... You, Lamont, get wrapped up in things like thought transmission. Get the obvious telephone.
That's why I have an efficient assistant like you.
Hello? Will you connect me with Dr. Waldeck, please? What? Are you sure? secretary's had no word either. No. Never mind, thank you.
Have to help your mother, Walter.
No, he hasn't been seen or heard from since he left your club last night at 11 o'clock.
Well, he is in trouble. He has been trying to communicate with me with a shadow.
Lamont, that other name, Star of Zealand. Say he's been trying to let you know where he is.
Yes, I'm sure of it. Star of Zealand. He said it sounded like the name of a ship. It's just possible. Hand me that newspaper, Margaret.
Got it here.
Shipping news. Let's see. Here it is. Sailing, arrivals, departures, in port. Margot. There is such a ship in port. Star of Zealand. A freighter, general cargo, pier 83. Margaret, your car outside?
Yes. You want me to drive you down to the dock?
Yes. Come on. There isn't a minute to lose. That ship is scheduled to sail at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Do you think Dr. Warwick is on board?
Yes, and I'm just as certain he's in trouble and needs help. Help from the shadow.
That must be the Star of Zealand over there, Lamont.
That's a couple more blocks, Margot.
Wouldn't it be better to let the police investigate? You have so little to go on. You can't even be sure there is anything wrong.
I can't convince you, Margot. What chance do you think I'd have of persuading the police to board a tramp steamer and search for a man I'd even reported missing?
But how on earth will you search a ship without help? It would take hours.
It won't be necessary. I'll know if there's anything wrong. It's Walter's there. 5 minutes after I walked through the gangplank, I'm going aboard of the Shadow.
We're nearly there.
Slow down, stop for the next pier.
Right.
I don't think you'd better wait, Margot. Perfection,
all the more reason for my waiting. Don't worry about me, Lamont. I'll lock the car doors. And another thing, if you're not back in 15
minutes... No, Margot, I may need more time. But keep the shortwave radio tuned in their usual band. If you don't hear from me in half an hour, then go ahead and notify the police.
All right, half an hour, but not a minute longer. I wish I knew what you were walking into, Lamont. I don't like this mental telepathy blind man's buff.
Neither do I, Margot, but... During the ride down here, I've had a stronger feeling than I did at first. Dr. Waldeck is in desperate need of help. Stay in the car, Margot. Lock the doors and sit tight until I come back. You hear from the shadow.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with the shadow in a moment to find out what new spot his enemies have put him on. But first, here's a word of advice to every motorist. Don't let wet, skiddy pavement put you on the spot.
Beware. How fast can you stop? Will your tires slip or grip? Don't gamble.
And motorists, if there is one tire that has taken the gamble out of skidding, it's the new Goodrich Silvertown with the Lifesaver Tread. For exhaustive road tests of the regular and premium price tires of America's 6 largest tire manufacturers, prove that the Silvertown gave greater skid resistance than any of the other tires tested. And don't forget, all during these tests, it was hands-off for Goodrich engineers. Instead, these tests were conducted by absolutely impartial engineers from America's largest independent testing laboratory, the Pittsburgh Testing Laboratory. What's more, some of the tires the Silvertown was tested against have list prices of 40 to 70% more. And that can mean only one thing, motorists. No other tire, regardless of price, can give you the superior skid protection of the Lifesaver Tread. With Lifesaver Tread Silvertowns on your car, you'll stop quicker, safer on a wet pavement than you've ever stopped before. Just think, the quickest non-skid stop ever with the Lifesaver Tread. Real blowout protection, too, with the famous Goodrich Golden Fly. And these two Goodrich safety features are now yours in the new Silvertown at no extra cost. Take a tip from me. For safety's sake, ride on Goodrich, safety Silvertown.
Well, my good Dr. Waldeck, what success have you had with our stubborn mental patient, eh?
None, Victor.
Come now, Doctor. You've been here on the Star of Zealand since last night.
Not by my choice. I admit that.
But surely you, one of the world's greatest psychiatrists, are not going to allow a deranged mind to stand between you and your chance of leaving this ship alive.
It is impossible, I tell you. Only one thought dominates the mind of Professor Hardy. If you had not allowed your servant to aggressively beat him, it would not be so difficult.
I did not have come down here to listen to excuses. I want that explosive formula from Professor Hardy. I mean to get it. Now.
Very well. He's there in the bunk sleeping. Perhaps you could succeed where I have failed.
You haven't failed. You haven't tried to penetrate his subconscious mind. But you're going to try. Come on.
Come here. Bring your whip.
The whip fails you once, Victor. It will fail you again. You brought me here against my will. But neither you nor that brute and his whip can make me reveal the secret knowledge of that man's mind. A shame that he sacrificed his reason to keep from you.
We shall see if you have the same courage and determination as Professor Hardy. Come on.
I am ready.
Very well, Dr. Mulder. One last chance. Get Hardy out of that bunk. Question him. Use the method you so eloquently described at your lecture last night. The method used to penetrate the subconscious of amnesia victims. Now, I refuse the possession of Professor Hardy's formula. The formula of the most powerful explosive ever known is vital to our country. Your country, Dr. Mulder. If you refuse, you are an enemy of your people.
I am a man of science. My nationality was an accident of birth.
You are a traitor.
In your eyes, perhaps. Just as in mine, you are a common thief.
Fool to come.
They see.
Do it, a fool.
And they coward.
Come on. Come on. We'll see who is a coward.
Yes. Mr. Richter, you
didn't touch him. What's the matter with you? Why did you put a whip away?
Something touched me. Knocked the whip from my hand.
You're crazy. You dropped it. Get it.
My swear. Something knocked it with my hand.
Pick up that whip, I say. Pick it up.
But Mr. Richter, the whip, it moves. It moves like a living thing. Like a snake.
That is it, Dr. Wernick. Trying to save yourself by fogging Ivan's mind. Making him see by hypnotic trance. Whips move like snakes, sir. Well, I'll show you. I can use a whip, too. Stay where you are, Doctor. Or do you think you can stop me pulling the trigger on this gun?
Your servant is not imagining things, Victor. He is not seeing things which have not happened. He is not hypnotized.
Something knocked the whip from my hand. I swear. Did you hear that?
Laughter.
Like the laughter of Satan. Something. Somebody.
You
heard it too. You heard it.
Yes, your master heard it.
Ah, the shadow. You heard my appeal. You have come.
The shadow.
Then it is possible. Telepathic communication between two minds. Far removed. Without mutual concentration of thought.
Yes, Dr. Waldeck, a theory has been proved, but a fact remains.
Is this another of your psychic tricks, Doctor?
Richter, surely your activities in espionage have brought you in contact with those who have warned you against the shadow.
The shadow? So you are the shadow. Waldeck advised you, did he?
Yes, but in a manner beyond your comprehension.
Come on, get out quick. Cross the iron door. Don't open it again until I order it.
Yes, I obey.
Your gun is trembling, Richter. Dr. Waldeck was right. You are a coward.
At least I don't hide in shadows. So, you've come to save Dr. Waldeck.
I came here in answer to his call for help, but now that I'm here...
Now that you're here, Shadow, you will remain. You have walked into a trap. A trap that will hold you until I am ready to deal with you in my own way. You and Waldeck and Professor Hardy there. You, Shadow, may even be useful in the event that the good doctor hears me.
Hello?
Captain. Victor speaking.
Yes, sir.
Order your crew to the post. Cut off. Be sent at once.
Well, it is not just at once, sir.
Obey my orders. Be sent at once.
Yes, sir. As you command.
Open the door. Don't waste your time in trying to get out of this hole here. Even you cannot walk through a steel door, Shadow. In a few hours, we will be at sea. And you'll be beyond help. As for you, Dr. Waldeck, I advise you to enlist the aid of the Shadow in securing Professor Hardy's secret, if you value your life. Yes? Come in.
You are getting underway, Mr. Victor.
Are there any further orders?
Yes, Captain. As soon as we are at sea, I want half a dozen of your best men. Armed with rifles and revolvers. Have them report here to me,
sir.
Why are we leaving so early? Oh, good morning, Captain.
Of course. Beg your pardon, but have you been in your cabin?
I haven't left it until now. Why?
Why do you ask? What's on? Let me speak up, man.
A young woman was seen coming on board just before we cast off, sir.
What? Are you sure?
Yes, sir. My second mate mentioned it, but thought it was Captain Sarah.
It couldn't have been.
Captain, take every member of you crew you can get. Search the ship. Find that woman and bring her here.
Yes, sir. We will find her as she's aboard.
Thank you.
Margot Lane. Margot Lane. Notify police and Coast Guard. Notify police and Coast Guard. Professor John Harding, Dr. Waldeck, prisoners in hold of Star of Dealand. Aboard Star of Dealand, proceeding to sea. Proceeding to sea. Repeat message. Margot Lane. Repeat. Repeat message. Margot. Margot, repeat. Why don't you answer? Why don't you answer?
Was that you talking, Shadow?
Yes. I was calling my assistant for help on my portable radio, but something's wrong. I can't get an answer.
I am profoundly sorry for the situation in which we find ourselves. Had I been able to communicate to you the exact nature of my difficulties, you would have been prepared.
I am prepared, Doctor. This ship will never pass beyond the 3-mile limit. It will be stopped search.
But how?
I'm going to use this radio again. Star of Dealand. Star of Dealand calling the Coast Guard. Star of Dealand calling the Coast Guard. Go ahead, Star of Dealand. Go ahead. Professor John Hardy, missing scientist. Wanted by the Secret Service, prisoner firing aboard Star of Dealand. Proceeding down bay, stop and search. Stop and search, prepare for armed resistance. That is all. Okay, Star of Dealand. A Coast Guard tire will investigate immediately.
You are indeed prepared, Shadow. But do not underestimate the cunning of Victor. At the first sign of danger, he will attempt to dispose of Professor Hardy and myself and you.
We must be prepared for that. Professor Hardy's mind completely gone.
No. For the past 24 hours, I have been feeding him. Have induced hypnotic sleep. He should be nearly rational now.
Better awaken him. No time to lose.
Very well. Professor Hardy. Come, Professor Hardy. It is time to wake him.
Margo,
when the ship barely had a schedule, I was sure something gone wrong. Don must have seen me coming aboard. They're searching the ship.
You're a godsend, Margo. Nothing be found on the ship. A Coast Guard cutter's on the way. You've got to get off before they arrive.
Don't worry about me. We're passing down the channel. It's only a couple of hundred yards ashore. Oh, Dr. Waldeck, he is here. He was aboard. But who's that other man?
Professor John Hardy. Quick, Margo, get off the ship. You've done more than enough just opening the steel door.
Oh, my Shadow. Don't worry, I can swim 10 times that distance. There's a cargo door open on the port side.
The guy's far out, Margo. And Margo, be careful of the suction of the propellers.
Come, Professor Hardy. Come, Professor Hardy.
Thank you. Thank you, Doctor. But, what has happened? Where is this? Victor.
We are still on the ship, but help is coming. Dear, very weak Shadow. Shadow, of the door. It is open, but how?
You must come with me. The door, it is open. They have escaped.
Doctor, get back behind the door. Out of sight.
Hey, that girl, she opened it. But they can't get off the ship. They can't be far from here.
Maybe they hide. Maybe.
Hey, you are a fool. Why did you close that door?
Oh, I did not touch it.
Now, Richter, did you walk into a trap?
You didn't have time to get away, Shadow.
Mr. Richter, the doctors, the professors, they are here.
Yes, sure. You like to have what you Americans call a showdown. Very well, you shall have it. After I communicate with my captain. Captain.
Yes, sir.
Quick, your men who are searching the ship, send them to this hold at once.
Immediately, sir.
Now, Shadow, we shall deal with you. Ivan, watch the good doctor and the professor. Their turn will come when we have finished with this Shadow once and for all.
You are too late, Richter. Listen.
There. Oh, the river police. Well, let them come. Before they can board us, there will be no trace of any of you.
Perhaps your captain is not so sure. He's calling you over the speaking tube.
Hello.
Coast Guard cutter off our port bow, sir. He has readied us to halt for search.
Order, full speed ahead and get your men down here.
We are not beyond the 3-mile limit.
Carry out my orders. Full speed ahead.
Yes, sir.
Desperate measures, but they will fail, Richter. They will fail. That was a blank, a warning. Your captain is being sensible. He stopped the engines.
Let them come. Let them search the ship. They'll find nothing. Because I'm going to shoot you. They'll never think to look for bodies in the ballast tanks. The gun!
No, Richter. You're not going to have murder if you're listed as crime.
Ivan, quick! I've got hold of the Shadow. Take my gun. It's on the floor. The Shadow's here between me and the wall. Shoot him!
Oh,
Oh, oh, there is nothing there. I see nothing.
Shoot him!
You are mad!
Shoot him!
Dr. Waldeck,
your gun! Pick it up!
Yes,
put up your hands, Victor.
No, you don't! You'll never turn me over to the police!
Sorry, I had to address you so hard, Dr. Waldeck. Coast Guard won't meet much resistance when they arrest you. You're a witness to what has happened here. Listen, Doctor.
The Coast Guard.
Yes, they are coming aboard. You are safe now, Dr. Waldeck. Your faith in the power of the mind saved you and Professor Hardy. Help him keep his secret. Perhaps at some future time, under more favorable circumstances, we shall meet again.
Listening to a dramatized version of one of the many copyrighted stories which appear in the Shadow magazine.
The weed of crime bears bitter fruit. Crime does not pay. The Shadow knows.
Characters and all the places named are fictitious. Any similarity to persons living or dead is purely coincidental.